Hi, welcome to Magdalen. I'm Lucy Barron and I'm doing a DPhil in Evolutionary Anthropology and I'm the MCR President here. Magdalen has a lively graduate body of about 230 students.
So I'm Alex, I'm doing a PhD in Ancient Greek here, and Magdalen actually has frankly ridiculously good library facilities. The new library, which you can see behind me, has recently been extended. It's got a fantastic collection of resources for most subjects, particularly classics. It's open 24/7. We've also got the old library, which houses the college's collection of early printed books and manuscripts. And there's also a specialist law library, just for law students, and the McFarlane Library, which houses books of particular interest to history students.
We're really lucky to have all this green space. We have the biggest grounds of the Oxford colleges, I think, or at least the biggest kind of open space like this. And the only college with deer in the grounds. They're quite friendly. Sometimes they come up to the railings. It's nice to have such an open space as part of the college.
Oh, during World War II, they were registered as turnips because.
It's because they were requisitioning meat for food purposes.
Yes, because the deer were going to be co-opted by the military, but then they were turnips, so they didn't qualify as enough food to be taken in.
A window with the flowers outside is the room that C.S. Lewis used to have, which we can
see. Before he went to Magdalen Cambridge.
I mean, there's students can sometimes go on this grass in summer, right? And people play play croquet or have picnics and revives and stuff out here.
Hello, I'm Eileen. I'm a second year DPhil in mathematics. This is a Holywell Ford, so where some graduate students live. And right behind there, there's also a squash court where we can use to play squash.
So welcome to Holywell Ford. This is one of the student staircases where graduate students live here at Oxford. So you're guaranteed 2 years worth of housing here. I've lived here for my first year and will actually be living in the same building my second year. So welcome to my room. And then Holywell Ford, we share a bathroom with the other six members of our stairwell, as well as a kitchen. So we have facilities for laundry and stuff out in the general quad. It's quite convenient because it helped me really make friends in my first couple of weeks here to be living with other grad students in my college. It makes you have a more unique, tight-knit community outside of just your faculty.
Yeah, so this is the outside of Holywell. We can hang out here in the summer, there's some barbecues we can use, and there's also a gardening patch that students are welcome to use to grow things with the gardening club here.
So just down that way is the Magdalen Punthouse, and during the summer, from May to the end of September, students can use any of the very large number of Magdalen punts, I think they're about 20, and go all the way down the river to the Thames.
Hi, my name is Ilse. I am doing a DPhil in Anthropology. We're currently in the MCR, which is not only the name for a student body of grad students, but also a physical space. So this is basically the living room for all grad students. We have a bar, which I also currently run. I'm one of the bar managers. We open the bar every Friday and also during BOPs, and we have other colleges visit, which is always a really great time. We also play board games here. People are free to come study, have a coffee, and just hang out with each other like you would in any living room.
As the MCR president, it's my job to oversee the committee, which works to put together a term card of events, including social things, welfare, support, etc. We also have really good academic support. As graduate students, when you start here, you're given a college advisor who is an academic outside of your department or faculty, who's someone to go to with problems that can be academic to help you in a kind of independently to your main supervisor. We also run symposia here in the MCR, which is a kind of informal small conference to discuss work and get feedback from people across disciplines. There's also a lot of financial support for things like conferences or running your own events that are academic related here. So altogether it's a really good, there's really good support for the academic side of your life here in Oxford. This is the Old Kitchen Bar, or the OKB, which is one of the general social spaces in college. It's one of the oldest parts of college as well. It's open as a bar in the evenings where you can come and get drinks and pizza, but it's also where people come for lunch, obviously, now. Yeah, and it's an extra place where we can hang out.
Hey, I'm Renee Ankin. I'm one of the welfare officers on our large welfare team. The idea is that we run events so that everyone, you know, can come in, drop by, have a chat about things they're struggling with. We also have structured support in terms of junior deans, senior deans that you can go to for help, to make sure that everyone sort of feels involved and feels that they've got people to go and speak to.
Hi, I'm Phil. I'm studying a Master's of Science in Biodiversity Conservation and Management. So this is the Magdalen Buttery. This is where students get their food, graduate students included. It's got a variety of different food. Today for lunch, we got some chicken, potatoes, and broccoli. And you pay over here, then you head out into the hall. And this is the famous Magdalen Dining Hall. In terms of food at Magdalen, there's a great variety of stuff, ranging from anywhere from regular breakfasts and lunches to more fancy formal events like formal dinners, guest dinners, and exchange dinners too. But if you don't know what to do any given night, this is a great place to meet new people and socialize.
My favourite thing about being at Magdalen would be the MCR community. It's a really warm and welcoming group of people. There's so much going on, you know, including dinners and events and talks and exhibitions and things, to days out and trips and things even outside of term time. So there's a lot of support and a lot of opportunities for, you know, meeting people and doing fun things.